Hi, today we will learn Indonesian language or Bahasa Indonesia about will or shall get used to. In this case, for example, eating bread every day. Saya will or shall akan get used terbiasa to dengan or untuk. For example, eating bread every day, eating makan bread roti every can be setiap, can be tiap day hari. Tiap is every, setiap is also every. We add the prefix se, so it means a or one or every. So when we say setiap can be every, but it's every. Which one you want you to use, setiap or tiap for every? In this case, you can use this menjadi, or you can skip this menjadi. It will not change the meaning of the sentence whether you use this menjadi or you skip this menjadi, because the terbiasa itself, it's already, the meaning is get used. Menjadi itself, it means become, or can be also get, or be. So, menjadi terbiasa, or terbiasa. Get used. This one be, become, or get, or yeah, be or become. I will just say it like that. Be or become. Will or shall can be akan or hendak. But in this case, I suggest to use akan, because hendak is more into am going to or is going to, are going to, into the to be with the going to, is am are going to, hendak. And it's a bit uncommon to use this word hendak with these words, so I suggest just use the akan instead of hendak. Dengan or untuk, in this case, we can translate this as to. For daily conversation or casual, most of the time we use dengan, dengan, ang, dengan, then untuk. Dengan is also a formal word, but if you say terbiasa untuk, is more formal than terbiasa dengan. But this is not the informal, this is also a formal one, but really formal, at least one step further formal, terbiasa untuk. Dengan itself is with, If you translate it the word itself dengan through the dictionary, dengan is with, untuk is to. That's why I keep making mistake with saying get used with, because I'm used get used with. This one is with, dengan is with. But in this case, we have to translate this dengan with to. Because in English, after get used, you use to instead of with. Even though in Indonesia, this is to or for, this is with. And we use this one more often than this one. Because this is, you can find it in the news or you can hear it in speech. Really formal. This one we already learned about this. And to say no or not, in English you put will or shall or shall and then not. In Indonesian language we say or we write the not first and then we use the will or shall, akan. So, we switch. Again, you can use or you can skip this menjadi, be or become. Saya tidak akan, I will not or I shall not. Saya tidak akan get used, can be menjadi terbiasa or terbiasa to dengan or untuk eating bread every day, makan roti setiap or tiap hari. This is the suffix. Se, it means a or one or every. To make it would, in Indonesian language, we have to add the time signal because for would, it will be the same. You see here, we still use akan. So in this case, we will not use the hendak. This one, tidak hendak, we never find sentence with tidak hendak. Tidak hendak, you will never find this tidak hendak. So of course here, there's no hendak. We just always use the akan, will at, or shall. So we have to add the time signal words, which one you like. Beside this, you can use other time signal words to say that it happens in the previous time, it happens in the past. You can say last week, last month, last year, or 2 years ago. These are the examples. Waktu itu. Waktu is time. Itu is that. So, that time. Ketika itu. Ketika is when. But we can say this one also as that time or at that time. Ketika is when or while. But this one, ketika itu is that time, or pada waktu itu. Pada can be for, can be at, waktu, time, itu, that, so at that time. Or you can use this, di or pada, at, saat or kala or waktu, it means time. Or hari, day, you can use itu, that, or tersebut. Tersebut can be translated as that, because the really exact translation is something that's already being said before. But in this case, we just put it to the same meaning with itu, that. Sebut is said, tersebut, have said, something that have been said before, have been talked about before. So we just add the time signal. You can use other time signal for something in the past. But in this case, I suggest to put also these words because it's kinda not common, uncommon if you don't use these words. If you just say saya or I, and then the rest of the sentence, it's kinda, so I just suggest add this word when you have to say or when you have to write something with would, because of course you add the time signal for the past of previous time, but it's not complete enough to make it as a good sentence. So berada is was or were, di or pada, at, posisi, position. So I suggest to use this one, because if not it's kind of a bit weird. Akan, in this case because we use the time signal, the previous time or the past, it will be would. If you want to say would not, you add the not, tidak, akan, would not or wouldn't. Terbiasa or menjadi terbiasa dengan or untuk, the rest is the same, makan roti setiap or tiap hari. So don't forget to add these words if you want to make the sentence into would or would not. This previous time signal words is kinda not good enough to make it as would or would not. So we have to add these words. Berada di posisi or berada pada posisi, was at or were, at or in, position. And now we will learn about the slang or the informal or the daily conversation, because most of the time we say it in daily conversation, slang edition or informal. Akan, It will be also akan, or bakal, or bakalan. Of course, we don't use the hendak, but hendak word also has the slang. The slang one for hendak is mau. Hendak is am going to, is going to, are going to. Mau is a formal word to say want, but we use this want for slang, replacing the hendak, is going to, am going to. Maybe in the future we will have sentence or we learn about this one. But mau itself is a formal word to say want. But in this case, it became a slang replacing this. Akan itself, will or shall. The slang one is, of course, we don't replace, we just use akan. Or bakal. Or we add the suf, the, oh, sorry, I was saying this one as suffix. This one is prefix. Prefix se. So this one with suffix an, bakalan. Slang words for akan, will or shall. Sometimes we write it into this one. This is how we write in informal way for this one. Of course, for this one, sometimes you write it like this, but we will not use this one anyway. And shortened version of this one, only this one. We see we just skip the, or the vowel. If we can skip the vowel, we just skip every vowel. This one, last one. We tend to skip the vowel or vowels. This one cannot be skipped because cannot be like only this one because it can be replaced into other words. So sometimes we skip the vowel if it will make into the words that we want to, but with this one we cannot escape this one. We have to use this one. Yeah. And menjadi. If you want to use menjadi, it becomes jadi. Or we write it into this one only. We skip the vowel. As long as we skip the vowel and we will think, oh, this is from this word, it's good enough. If we skip this, it will go to other words. So we need this one. And terbiasa, the casual, biasa, or bisa, or kebiasa, or kebiasaan. Even though this bisa, it means able or can, but in casual we used to replacing this used or get used. And this one, kebiasaan, is a formal word. This is also a formal word. Kebiasaan is a formal word to say habit, but it can be slang or casual to replace this get used, terbiasa. And dengan or untuk, we can replace with sama or ama, or buat, or this how you write it, slang or informal. Sama a formal word to say same or similar, but this word also replace dengan or untuk. It means to. The formal word sama is same or similar, but if this word replacing this, it becomes a slang or informal to say to or with. Sama is with, the slang. Buat is casual or daily word we use replacing untuk or for or to. So you can use replacing this. And we already know that saya or I, it will be gua, gue, or like this, the way you write it. And no or not, the slang one is this one, enggak, 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 or this how you write it, kagak, kagak. Informal or slang words to say no or not. Thank you.